Hello, everybody. Larry here, and welcome. Larry's Fountain Pen. Today, it's about ink. A little bit of ink. So, if you're not busy or in a rush, don't touch that button. Kind of grab yourself a snack, a soda, a coffee, a brew. Kick it back and kind of hang out with me for a bit today. I'm going to go over some a couple of inks that I got in, and I'm going to do some swabs on them and let you decide if you like them or not. So here's the ink that I got in from China, the Jinhao Orange, that I'm real anxious to check out. And here's the ink that a friend of mine, Doug, got me when he was in Dallas at the Mont Blanc, and it's a midnight blue. So let's get on with it. First, let's go ahead and do the Mont Blanc Midnight Blue. And Mont Blanc is one of my favorite all inks. I do have a lot of favorites. It comes really nicely packed and secured in the box. And I do love the Mont Blanc bottles, don't you? Yeah, they really are amazing inks. They're a great ink. One of the best ink out there, in my opinion, and great for your fountain pens, in my opinion. Of course, we would have a lot of people that would debate with that, but that's just me. You know, I'm an ink guy. I like inks, and there's really not a lot of inks that I don't like, but right now, here we go. And I'm going to do it on the Coloring. If you're not familiar with it, here's what they look like. They've been around a while. Colo ring right there. And this is 100 pounds or 160 GSMs, acid-free, okay? Right there. Then I'm going to do it on Tomo River paper, then regular notebook paper, so you get an idea what the ink actually looks like, okay? So let's get this baby going. First time for me to check out the ink, and I am excited. If the darn thing comes off. Boom. And let's see here. We go. I guess I'm just going to do it this way. Why not? Sometimes I do it the other way, but why not? These are my swabs, but I like the other way as well. Okay, so I'm going to let that sit a while. Close that up, and let me get some Tomo River paper right here. And we're going to just do that as well. And last but not least, I'm going to do some Rhodia paper. And last but not least, let me get some regular notebook paper. That way you can see what it's going to look like. So let's put these aside, and then we'll do a little bit of ink comparison. Okay, here is the Mont Blanc Midnight Blue. And here's the Hero 232 Black Blue. And then here's the Diamine Blue Black. Then here is the Nick Stewart Randall Blue Black. Then I just thought I'd throw some of these in for the heck of it. Here's the Noodler's 54th Massachusetts. Kind of looks kind of close, doesn't it, Mr. Nelson?
Similar.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. And then here's the Noodler's Bad Blue Heron. Nah, not really, but it has maybe kind of reminds me of it, but it's not really as pronounced in the Bad Blue Heron, but it's a nice ink. Last but not least, here's the Birmingham South Shore Luster. You can see that. Okay. So those are what I have. I thought I'd share with you now. Let's go, before I go to the other one, we're going to go into the inks. Here's what it looks like on the Tomo River paper. Okay. And did you want to see the other side? Sure you do. Why not? We have it out. And no bleed through. You have some show through, but no bleed through. And I really inked it up real good. So, best of all paper for me is Tomo River paper. Great job. Okay. Set that aside. And on the Rhodia dot grid paper, this is what it looks like. It looks really nice on the paper as well. And really no show through. But then the paper is 80 G's, you know. So 52 G's, really thin compared to the 80 G's. And last but not least, you have your standard notebook paper, composition paper right here. Here's what it looks like there. And I'm going to just take that out. And here's what it looks like on the back. You got some show through and a slight bleed through. Not real bad, but it is bleeding through. All right, so let me just close that up. Set this aside, and I really got to organize my inks, I think. Get some different inks and keep all the colors kind of all together. All together now. Now we're going to do the Jinhao orange. Okay. Interesting how you picked.
Okay. What, that's not an orange?
Well, it's a dragon napalm. I don't think it's going to be close to that.
Well, I haven't seen it yet. I don't know what it looks like.
Right there. That's what it's supposed to look like. So we'll see what it looks like out of the box. And it does come packaged really well and secure. And I do like that. Okay. So put that back in there. And we'll first do it on the coloring first. Nice glass bottle. Nice orange. I do like that orange. Nice. Really nice. I'm impressed. I do like orange. And while we have this out here, we'll go ahead and do that on the regular sheet of notebook paper. Then we'll do it on the Rhodia paper. And last but not least, on the Tomo River paper, 52 G's. Okay. Nice and wet. Better pick that up before I lose it. And now we'll kind of start seeing what we get here. Now this is the Sunny Orange by Jinhao. Really a nice, beautiful orange. I really am intrigued over this orange. And we'll try to find the Noodler's Dragon Napalm. Nah, not really. But how about the Diamond Eternal Internal orange it has there. I was wondering if I meant to put Inferno, but internal. Close. There's a Monteverde. I can't. Is that Mandarin orange?
Yes.
There. A little darker. But here's one. The. Can you pronounce that? So I won't butcher it.
Kenmokusu Duraflex.
It's a Japanese sailor gentle. Yep. kind of close to it. What do you say there?
Pretty close.
Yeah, the Diamond Corral doesn't do no justice for it. Now here's one, the Diamond Pumpkin. And the Mont Blanc Lucky Orange.
That's really close.
Yeah, really close. Really, really close. And last but not least, the Diamond Orange. Right there. So these two, out of all of them, look really, really close. And I'm thinking next would be the Sailor Gentle Kim... How do you say that?
Kinmokusu.
Kinmokusu. Okay. That would be... These are the closest ones, in my opinion, on the color chart. So, that's how they flow. So, before I forget, let's do this again. On the notebook paper, not bad. On the back, you see some really good bleed through. And on the Tomo River paper, there's how it looks. And last but not least, you do see some show through, as you will for thin paper. This is just Tomo River paper. And it holds up really well with the paper. Really well. My favorite paper. So, there you have it. Oh, last but not least, I almost forgot. On the Rhodia.grid, it looks really nice on the Rhodia. And really no show through as well. But then this is what, did I say 80 or 90? 80 G's on paper. So there you have it. And that's going to conclude today's ink swaps for the Mont Blanc Midnight Blue and the Jinhao Sunny Orange. Hey, thanks for joining me today. Stay safe and don't text and drive. I'll check you guys out later. Peace out.